Not only are we going to look at the value of these items, we're also going to look at the history of this often missed category. Hey, it's Don. Today we're going to delve into the GAR, which is a fraternal organization that was founded by veterans of the Civil War of the Union Army. The GAR, or the Grand Army of the Republic, was founded in 1866 in Springfield, Illinois, and it actually grew from just one post to hundreds of them across the country. Now, the GAR lasted until 1956, when the last living surviving member passed away and it was dissolved. Now, at the peak of the GAR's membership in 1890, there were more than 410,000 active members, all of which served in the Union Army. Here's some footage from a 1913 reunion at Gettysburg. Patches from uniforms can be worth some money. I don't think I've ever seen one less than 30, and I've seen them all the way up into the $300 range. Many different types of patches can be found as well, like this example here. Many of the numbers on there are for posts, GAR posts, which would be like a local establishment, a local branch of the GAR. Now, other items that you can find would be buttons off of the uniforms, whether they'd be vest size buttons, jacket size, cuff size. Some of them would also go on their kepi as well. Now, ribbons are another area, and probably one of the biggest ones out there. Usually $20 is the bottom end I can get out of any ribbon that I run across, but I have seen individual ribbons and awards running up to the $4,000 range many times. There are thousands of different varieties of ribbons and medals as well, so you can run into all various types, sizes, and constructions of them, some with silk attachments, others without. A large number of them are designated by state or post as well, and can be tied to these reunions. Hats of various types are another area of collectibles in the GAR field. Many different hats can be found in various different styles, like the hardy hat or a kepi. The price is distinguished by the actual condition of the hat, as well as the model, the design, and who possibly owned it. Having provenance or knowing who owned the hat can add a considerable amount to the value of these sorts of items. Now, tied along with the hats themselves are the hat pins that go on the hats. Now, just the pin off the front of any type of hat like this can go for at least $15. I've seen them as high as $250. It just depends on the unit, if there's anybody famous tied to it or something along that line. Now, lapel pins are something else you will find. Some are C-clasp on the back, and some are buttonhole examples. But there are many different versions of these, and price will depend on the style or version you have. $15 is about the bottom end on any of these that I see, going up into the hundreds. Belts and buckles are another area that's highly collectible. The buckles themselves can usually go for at least $50 just for the buckle. You might be able to add 100 or more onto a very nice belt that would go with it. Now, a combination set that's ID'd to someone very specific with provenance can go for some incredibly good money. Hundreds and hundreds of dollars if you have one ID'd. Now, if it belongs to a high-ranking officer, say a general or something like that, it could go for far more than that as well. Another very hot collectible in the GAR section are swords and scabbards. Many times they are presentation pieces that were given to a commanding officer, somebody who did something very heroic, or something along that line. Many times if a soldier died in combat, they may have presented one, say, to the second in command or something along that line. Most of the swords carry a pretty darn decent value. Some of the swords would be made by someone very specific, or they may be dedicated to someone very well known, and that would increase greatly the amount of money something like this is worth. And it could go into the thousands if it was for, say, a general. Now, uniforms and uniform pieces can sell for some good money also. A jacket, a trench coat, overcoat, the pants even, the shirt, a vest, anything that was issued to the Gar or any members of the Gar can go for some incredibly good money. Many times, Gar members would use their original uniform from the war that they were issued and just alter the emblems on it. They'll put Gar pieces and things like that on them. So many times, the uniform piece could be older than the actual establishment of the Gar itself. Now, flags and banners of all types can be found for Gar. You can find them for regiments, battalions, all sorts of things. Even corps you can find them for also. Many are sponsored by specific posts as well, and they may have like a post number or something along that line, or the battalion name specifically stated on some of these. Items that go with it could be the eagles off the flagpoles, or the harnesses that you would strap around with the belts to actually hold the flag in parade formation. Now, real photos, cabinet cards, or anything along that line of Gar members in uniform can sell for some good money. The same goes for real photo or real picture postcards. Anything with real images, real photographs that were developed and printed out can go as well. Any of that sort of thing. It does not matter the type of image that it is. Any of those do well. Now, postcards in general, just postcards advertising, talking about, or promoting anything related to Gar can also sell. $10 to say $30, $40, $50, or even more, depending on what it's for. But the bottom end is usually around $10 for any Gar-related postcard. Most anything you could think of that you could advertise for the Gar, they made it, such as sheet music, like this Gar March one here. There are many different sheet musics related to the Gar. There are some for very specific posts as well. There are playing cards, several different styles of decks marked with their actual emblem on it. There's Victorian trade cards advertising encampment. There are also cigarette pack labels that promoted the Gar as well. Things that you can find. For most of the encampments, they also made programs that would advertise who was there, what was going on, maybe performances by major bands, and things along that line. You can also find glass tumbler souvenirs from many of these same events, as well as china and pottery plates from these same ones. There's ashtrays and all sorts of different things. Now, my personal favorite Gar piece, something that's actually in my collection, is this letter from Frederick Dent. Now, Frederick Dent is the son of Ulysses S. Grant, one of our presidents. And this letter actually talks about him asking the Gar post that his father was a member of to actually stand by and escort the body of his mother, the first lady of the country during Ulysses S. Grant's presidency. The letter is very touching and it's signed multiple times. It's very personal, mentioning out very specific people. Now, Frederick Dent was also a general, just like his father, Ulysses S. Grant. Frederick Dent was on a battlefield when he was a teenager during the Civil War himself. So, in all honesty, he was a veteran of the war and was entitled to Gar membership as well. Gar items can be found all over the place, but if you are unaware of what the Gar is or what the value is of the items, you are surely going to miss out in these sorts of things. Well, there you have it. Hopefully that gave you some ideas, some thoughts. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button down below. You can also hit the bell icon to be notified if I post new content or go live. Subscribe and tell all your friends. We'll be right back.
is the rugged new G.I. Joe adventure team. At dawn, G.I. Joe heads out across the desert in search of a mysterious missing mummy. Suddenly, an earthquake. No time to lose. Joe must get the mummy out. Can G.I. Joe win his race against time? Find out in The Secret of the Mummy's Tomb, one of the exciting G.I. Joe adventure team sets. G.I. Joe, now with lifelike hair from Hasbro.